house.
It's all about hands-on learning for these kids. Fox's Beth Parker takes us to the classroom, which is actually an archaeological dig at what once was a slave site.
Shoveling, scraping, sifting. It takes a lot of sweat to piece together history.
Right now, I'm in the process of excavating what we assume to be the yard of the structure.
Alex Brueggemann is a senior at Howard University. This summer, he is working for the National Park Service. His classroom is a slice of the Monocacy National Battlefield near Frederick. This place, once called L'Hermitage, was owned by planters from the colony of Saint-Domingue, what is now Haiti.
My father is from Haiti.
So even though he is digging just 6 inches below the surface, for Alex, it is much deeper.
It's a really deep feeling, greater respect for where you come from.
Now, in the late 1700s, this was a plantation. They think there were about 6 slave dwellings here. The stakes you see mark the corners of each of the buildings.
Even though slavery is something that happened long ago in the past, we still deal with the effects of that institution to this day, and it's really shaped who we are and how we built this country.
Slavery is kind of associated with people being treated as subhuman, but when we find things like maybe a marble, which we have actually found, makes you realize that, you know, they were children and they were playing. They're having regular human interactions.
Shayla Monroe says there are all kinds of archaeologists.
Some people love structures, some people love ceramics, some people love stone tools. I love trash. I love digging in people's trash, you know, from hundreds of years ago.
This is dusty, draining work. On hot days, they beg for a breeze.
We all got bitten by this bug. It's like we caught this weird archaeology fever. It is incredibly addictive.
Shayla says when you hold something in your hand that was held by someone hundreds of years ago, you can't stop yourself. You just have to keep digging.
I'm sure you